Hello, this is our time together where we spend time with one another in the Word of God. So, if you want to get a hold of any of our material and so forth, go to mfhlv.com. That's mfhlv.com. And we have, archives that you can look at, get blessed by from previous teachings, pertaining to all kinds of different, situations. I want to mention to you guys, we've had one of our brothers in India was martyred. He was killed for the cause of Christ. In this coming Sunday, we're going to be sending a special offering to India because, with this COVID-19 and the persecution that is going on there in India is, it's rough on them. So we're going to be sending them a special offerings, for food and all kinds of things. Those are brothers and sisters, that are being persecuted there in India. Yesterday I spoke to our lead pastor over there, and he informed us that two others had been martyred, and so forth. So we just want to be a blessing, to India, and our hearts, break because they laid their lives down, for Jesus, for the gospel. All right. I want to talk with you about you being like Jesus, and we've been talking about it, you cannot be cursed. I just spoke about people being martyred. Well, when you are martyred, you are not cursed. You've entered a group of very unique people in heaven. Those that have laid their life down, for the kingdom. But in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 17 and 18, everybody wants to be free. I mean, all of the stuff that we have going on here in America and in other nations is because people want to be free. Everybody wants to be free. But what is true freedom? When you're truly free, you're free from any curse because you have found freedom inside yourself. You will never find freedom outside of yourself until you find freedom inside of yourself. Did you get that? I know. So let me read you these verses. Now, the Lord is that Spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. When the Spirit of God is inside of you, you have liberty. You're free. What do you mean free? You're free to be like God. You're free to be like Jesus. That's the purpose of the Spirit of God. I remember as a little boy, I would see the ministers go in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I could relate to a Father. I could relate to a Son. But the Holy Spirit was like, huh? The Holy Spirit is the spirit of freedom. It sets you free from condemnation, the worst part of your own self and others. And it gives you the liberty to be like Jesus. So we're going to read both verses together. 2 Corinthians 3, verses 17 and 18. Now, the Lord is that Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Not maybe. There is. Why? Because the Spirit of God is liberty, freedom. Next verse. But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even by the Spirit of the Lord. Guess whose image we're being changed into from glory to glory? His. That's why the Spirit of the Lord gives you freedom to be like God. It gives you freedom to be like Jesus. And that's the freedom that you need and I need, constantly flowing like a river through our lives, through our minds, through our actions. Notice that it doesn't say that, you know, you have to be tortured for it.
Hallelujah.
Whom the Son has set free is free indeed. And this is a freedom that comes that you receive by faith from God, through the Spirit of God. And then you have such freedom that if you do have to be martyred, guess what? You'll have the power to lay down your life for the gospel. You know, I remember some years ago I was thinking about this, you know, when I was just got started in ministry, and I was going, boy, it would be really hard, you know, to die for Jesus if you were being tortured. I had no idea what I was talking about. Now, I'm a little bit older. I was 24 back then. Now I am very, very old compared to then. You get that? I'm 69 years old. And guess what? Now I've changed my philosophy. I go, it'd be easier to die for Jesus than it would be to live for him for 50 years. You get it? But then comes the anointing. The anointing is the ability to do that which you cannot normally do. And the anointing lets you know, and it puts you in a position for where the Spirit of the Lord is. There's freedom, and you can be like Jesus. You're free to be like Jesus. Then it sets you free from, well, what is harder? To die for him or live for him? There's liberty to die for him and to live for him. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom to be able to do anything. Jesus said, nothing shall be impossible to him that believes. All right. God's purpose is to eliminate curses off of you. Are you ready? In Revelation 22, verse 3, it says, and there shall be no more curse. No more. No more curse of murders, of rape, of prejudicism, of hatred, unforgiveness. In Revelation 22 it says, and there shall be no more curse. This is the climax of everything. But the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it. Guess what? There'll be no more curse. And that Lamb, the throne of God, and the Lamb, which is Jesus, shall be in the place of the curse forever. This is when it's all done. But you start now dealing with curses and destroying them. For there shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it. Where? In heaven. Hallelujah. And his servants shall serve him. Why? They'll have the freedom. They have the freedom to be like Jesus. Did you get that? Do you know that the curse even hit heaven? When Lucifer rebelled against God and there was a war in heaven, and 1/3 of the angels rebelled against God, against what was good. Even heaven was touched by the curse of war. But guess what? Hallelujah. Even heaven needeth the spirit of liberty. In the ultimate outcome, in heaven, because where did the curse start? In heaven, it didn't start down here. The war started where? In heaven. Did you get that? And that's why it's making this proclamation, because it started in heaven. And there shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it. In heaven, no more curse down here. Every curse completely destroyed. And his servants shall serve him. Why? They'll have the liberty to serve him out of a pure heart. Last verse. And they shall see his face. And his name shall be in their foreheads.
Hallelujah.
Your mind will be completely blown. That's why it's on the forehead. The name of God will be the seal on your mind. Your mind won't drift off into ridiculous things anymore. But the name of God will be upon your mind. Guess what the cowboys used to do? They used to put a mark on the cattle saying, that cattle belongs to this. Can't steal it. Can't do anything. It belongs to this ranch. God is going to brand your forehead with his name. And that means that this mine is mine. Nothing can go into it that is not mine. That's what I mean by blow your mind. We used to use that back in the hippie days. So, no curse. We start here dominating the curse.
Thank you.
And curses.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. That's why we've been doing this all week. You need to go back if you've missed these, any of these, go back to Monday. The title is, You Cannot Be Cursed. You cannot. Obey the blessing. Obey the blessing that I just shared with you. You can be free to be like Jesus. All right. Give your heart to Jesus if you haven't. And if you're a Christian, don't settle. Don't settle for a minute part of God. Go for all of God. So you can be your all for humanity. They need us, you know. Jesus said, I have you down here. I have you down there. To be my hands, to be my heart, to be my eyes, my hands, my feet. The Bible says we are the body of Christ. And they need us. They need you. They need you to be sold out 100% so they can get 100% of what God has for them through you. Okay? All right. Tomorrow's Friday, and we'll be finishing off the week. May the Holy Spirit haunt you with his peace. May nothing else haunt you but the Spirit of God in his peace. We always dismiss by throwing him a kiss. God bless you.